thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Heather Sells.
And I'm Charlene Israel. Investigators are on the hunt for a suspect caught on tape in that failed terror attack that could have set off a deadly fireball in Times Square. Officials are focusing on finding a man who was videotaped near the SUV where the bomb was found. Police say the gasoline and propane bomb could have sprayed shrapnel and metal parts with enough force to kill pedestrians and knock out windows on one of America's busiest streets, full of Broadway theaters and restaurants on a Saturday night.
Clearly, it was the intent of whoever did this to cause mayhem, to create casualties. We're doing an in-depth analysis now of the material that was used. That material that was in the gun box will determine what that was. But it was, I think it's just a sober reminder that New York is clearly a target of people who want to come here and do us harm.
Investigators are looking for a middle-aged man seen shredding his shirt near the SUV rigged with a bomb in Times Square. The surveillance video shows an unidentified white man in his 40s slipping down an alley and taking off his shirt. He's seen looking back toward the smoking vehicle and putting the first shirt in a bag. Moments later, witnesses saw smoke coming from the vehicle. Police were alerted and the surrounding area was evacuated.
We are very lucky, thanks to alert New Yorkers and professional police officers, we avoided what could have been a very deadly event.
Detectives also are en route to a town in Pennsylvania where a tourist believes he may have captured the suspect's image on his video camera.
Police have already identified the registered owner of the dark-colored Nissan Pathfinder and are looking to interview him. The vehicle's identification number was obscured and its license plates came from a car found in a Connecticut repair shop. Meanwhile, President Obama says he will do what is necessary to protect the American people.
And I'm going to continue to monitor the situation closely and do what it takes at home and abroad to safeguard the security of the American people.
A Pakistani Taliban group claimed credit for the failed attack, but New York police say there is no evidence to back up that claim. The group has falsely claimed responsibility for attacks in the past.
Devastating thunderstorms in Tennessee and Mississippi brought flooding that left at least 15 people dead this weekend. Scores of highways are closed, and all eyes are now on the Cumberland River. It is expected to crest at its highest level since the early 60s. This aerial footage from the Tennessee Department of Transportation shows flooding in the Nashville area. You can see a building which once belonged to the Lighthouse Christian School floating away. Authorities say the water rose so high and with so much power that little could be done to keep the building anchored. The governor of Tennessee has called the state's Army and National Guard in to help. In Kentucky, flooding has forced some to evacuate their homes. It's also washing out roads and threatening bridges.
Disaster crews are pursuing all possible options to stop or slow the disastrous oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico. At least 210,000 barrels of oil have poured into the Gulf of Mexico from the damaged wellhead that's threatening the entire Gulf Coast. The weather is playing a part. Stormy conditions have kept the oil out to sea, giving crews additional time to fight the slick. But it's also hampered efforts to lay thousands of feet of boom to divert the oil.
Wind's blowing 35 knots out there. They got 4 to 5 foot seas to contend with, and the rope that they've got is poly, which is basically just nylon. It's super cheap.
Meanwhile, BP is drilling a relief well to try and stop the flow of oil into the Gulf, a process that could take months. In a visit to the region on Sunday, President Obama promised a federal response to the crisis and accountability for the company responsible.
BP is responsible for this leak. BP will be paying the bill. But as President of the United States, I'm going to spare no effort to respond to this crisis for as long as it continues. And we will spare no resource to clean up whatever damage is caused.
More bad news for Gulf fishermen this morning. Commercial and recreational fishing in the Gulf has been banned from the Mississippi River to the Pensacola Bay for the next 10 days.
President Obama has issued a proclamation declaring Thursday, May 6th, the National Day of Prayer. Now, that's despite a federal judge's ruling that the Day of Prayer is unconstitutional. Last month, federal judge Barbara Crabb ruled that such a proclamation is a violation of church and state. However, she suspended enforcement while it's under appeal. National Day of Prayer Chairman Franklin Graham said Crabb's ruling had a positive effect by focusing people on the need to pray. Graham said that if he ever meets Crabb, he'll, quote, give her a big hug and a kiss. The president's proclamation calls on Americans to give thanks for the many blessings God has bestowed upon our nation.
Well, some Christians took a head start by gathering to pray in our nation's capital this weekend. They came from all 50 states, and as John Waggy reports, the focus of May Day 2010 was repentance.
They met at the Lincoln Memorial under a warm spring sun, calling on God to forgive the people and heal the land.
We did not point at the world, but God, we point our finger back at ourselves as Christians for what we have done, for what we have allowed our eyes to see.
Move upon your people in such a way, Lord, that we cannot take credit for it. That the credit goes to you, Lord.
Janet Porter, the coordinator of May Day 2010, says the nation is under a curse as set out in the Bible for, among other things, shedding innocent blood through abortion and beginning to turn our backs on Israel.
The good news is, as we remember our covenant with God, we're going to repent for the sins that have taken us away from God, and we're going to renew that covenant with God.
During the gathering, prayer was offered for every state.
We covenant with you, God, and we speak in agreement with you today that there will be a healing move of God in Nevada.
Sharon Nye from Los Angeles is burdened over human trafficking and the pornography industry.
We knew that without a doubt, this is an issue that is so heavy on God's heart. And we're here to repent on behalf of the adult entertainment industry that has pretty much polluted and defiled the nations of the earth.
There were prayers for the different generations, including the young.
Just that God would come through. You know, I see it in my school and I see it in the nation, just how it's disintegrating and how important it is that we come back to Jesus.
Running back to you.
John Waggy, CBN News.
Turning overseas now, two bombs exploded near buses full of Christian students in Mosul, Iraq on Sunday. The blast killed one bystander and injured about 100 others. Now, the attacks came just days after an al-Qaeda-linked group issued new threats against Iraq's Christians. According to the Voice of the Martyrs, Ansar al-Islam sent an email to the Chaldean Bishop of Baghdad, issuing a warning to Christians to leave the country. The letter said, quote, "There's no more room for you, you infidels among the Iraqi Muslims. Our sword shall be placed upon your necks and the necks of your followers." Christians say violence and threats against them have increased since the recent election. Many are staying away from their churches and Christian businesses.
Two pastors in Uzbekistan are in prison this week for sharing the gospel. It happened in the city of Timirs. The Christians are spending 15 days behind bars. The Muslim mother of a recent convert said the two men baptized her son in the Russian God. Christians in the former Soviet Republic are prohibited from sharing their faith. According to the Voice of the Martyrs, police in the city of Termez raided Christian homes and fined six believers more than $500 each for possessing Bibles in the Uzbek language. The average Uzbek earns less than $250 per month.
Thousands of people in the Philippines have lost their homes due to a huge fire, but Operation Blessing and churches have been quickly responding to the need.
In a shanty town in Manila, residents desperately tried to save their belongings as fire raced through their homes. Two people died in the tragedy, and more than 7,000 families were left homeless. Many residents have pitched makeshift tents where their houses used to stand, breathing air polluted by the burned buildings and left exposed to the scorching heat of summer. Olive Garduk worries for the health of her four children. Their home is now some cartons and a bedsheet over their heads. While Olive and the other victims spend the day waiting in line for relief supplies, her children look for scrap materials in the fire debris that they can sell for income.
I pity my children because of our difficult condition. They get sick because of the changing weather, but I cannot do anything. Our house is gone now, and I don't know how long we can live like this.
In a crisis like this, many here see Operation Blessing as a source of divine intervention, as it partners with a local church to minister to the victims.
For now, the operation blessings giving canned goods, used clothes, bottled water, and also mats. We counsel them, we talk to the victims, and we pray for them.
Some relief operations are carried out in the streets, but here, Olive and other fire victims sit comfortably inside the church. Everyone is given the chance to pray to receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. The goal is to offer a physical and spiritual oasis, even for just a few minutes, allowing survivors to unload their burdens to God. Olive was able to bring home supplies and clean clothes for her children, as well as a heart filled with hope.
I cannot complain to God. I am still very thankful that all of us are alive. My whole family, we are still together. I would like to thank Operation Blessing for the help that they gave us. This means a lot to us.
A water purifying station was also set up in the area to provide free, clean drinking water.
It's difficult to get drinking water. We have to pay, but now you give it to us for free. Thank you, Operation Blessing.
The government says it will take several months before the victims' lives can be restored to normal. That's why Operation Blessing will continue to provide counseling, relief goods, and feeding programs for the fire victims in the days ahead.
Coming up, the power of prayer to change a nation's destiny. Our talk with prayer leader Dutch Sheets when we return.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to worship.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Glory is the Lord God.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's
50 powerful songs of faith.
Amazing love,
get Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for only $24.99.
Here I am for worship.
But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and we'll take $15 off. That's right, you get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on 3 CDs for just
$9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Earlier, we told you about the May Day prayer meeting in Washington, D.C. this weekend.
And later this week, churches across the country will take part in the National Day of Prayer. Recently, CBN's George Thomas spoke with prayer leader Dutch Sheets about America's crucial need for prayer.
Last March, Dutch Sheets issued a very special call to prayer for America. He is with us now to tell us more. What is this call to prayer? Why now? Why for this nation?
You know, because I've had this passion that has arisen in me recently that two things are happening simultaneously. This nation is headed toward further judgment. I see more judgment coming to the economy, violence, terrorism. But at the same time, it's a part of God's mercy as this happens. He allows it to turn us toward Him. I see a great awakening coming. And what I see God doing now and what's coming in this next great awakening is a dual thing. It's awakening, revival, but it's also a sense that, wait a minute, we better go back into the culture And we better take media back. We better take government back, education back. What God's doing this time is He's preparing us simultaneously for a great revival, but also He's putting a mindset in His people to go into the culture and say, you know what? We're supposed to disciple them. God's plan is for us to move back into our purpose as a nation, which is to be a light to the nations of the earth. And I think He wants that, and I think we're still that strength. It's still there in us if we just tap into it. And I think we're going to. When this awakening comes, it always happens. It's not only just for ourselves. People begin to get infected with God's heart for the lost everywhere. God's not finished with America. We are still a voice. We haven't been the best voice of late, but we are still such a voice in the earth. God has to have this nation, or it's gonna hinder the harvest. We're coming into the greatest harvest the world's ever seen.
Why is this judgment taking place? What's going on in our society that you sense God is allowing this judgment to come?
Well, you know, there's several things in Scripture that bring judgment. Shedding of innocent blood, covenant breaking, idolatry, immorality. America has all of those and more, and we've turned from God. And so God is coming to change this. I believe there's shaking, there's judgment coming, but it's to turn our hearts, just like Israel, back to Him. Like Joel said, God's coming. He's going to shake this thing up, but He's a merciful God. Call on Him, and He's going to pour out His Spirit on your sons and daughters, and they're going to prophesy and see visions, and all this is going to happen. And that's where we are in America. We're at a point where both are starting to happen.
And you think this is going to be the key to turn the nation
Most
around,
definitely.
The young people?
You know, God started telling me in 91 that this revival, this new wave that was coming would begin with the youth. Showed me a very dramatic vision of them. And then confirmed it to me. It's already started to happen now. And it's beginning with the young people, most definitely, absolutely. And I knew it would. And God is awakening a sense of destiny in them. That's what's happening. They're crying out for purpose. The number one question asked on college campuses to the counselors and teachers, what is my purpose? I'm looking for purpose. God's about to awaken a sense of purpose in a generation that has none. And they're going to be radical warriors on fire for Jesus. It is starting to happen.
And the man who is enabling and being used by God to awaken the young people, but also our nation, Dutch Sheets, is always a pleasure to have you on the broadcast.
That's very humbling. Thank you.
You're most welcome.
Up next, evidence that God is shaking America again.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where He performed His miracles, to see where He taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American Plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American Plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American Plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American Plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American Plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American Plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where He performed His miracles, to see where He taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Welcome back to the CBN News Channel. If you're just joining us, here's the top story we're following today. New York City police are in search of a suspect captured on videotape near the SUV where the Times Square bomb was found. So far, police say there is no evidence Al-Qaeda or the Taliban is behind the failed attack.
104 years ago, the Azusa Street Revival began. As the baptism of the Holy Spirit spread, it brought incredible church growth in the 20th century.
Now, Christian leaders believe a new spirit-filled revival has begun in the 21st century. As Mark Martin explains, this time it's beginning in the heartland of America.
God, we pray for the great awakening in America.
Thousands of people converge on the Oklahoma campus of Oral Roberts University to pray for a fresh outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
No matter what your faith is, the greatest religious story of the last 100 years is the growth of Pentecostal religion. From a handful of people in downtown Los Angeles to 640 million Pentecostals worldwide in 100 years. There's never been anything like it. Now the question is, what about the next 100 years?
That was the question facing those who gathered for Empowered 21, the Global Congress on Holy Spirit Empowerment in the 21st Century. Organizers believe it will lead to a new era of ministry.
There are world changers in this room that will do something significant beyond what any generation has done.
Empowered 21 Chair Billy Wilson says it will take divine power to accomplish the goal.
It's critical for us, if we're going to evangelize the world in the 21st century, that we have the power of the Holy Spirit residing in us, flowing through us, bringing the character of Jesus in us.
It was Jesus himself who told his first century disciples they needed to wait for the Holy Spirit before evangelizing their world. Jerusalem pastor Wayne Hilsden says today's Christians also need the Day of Pentecost experience.
Well, the baptism of the Holy Spirit is for power. And Jesus promised that in Acts chapter 1, verse 8, and you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you to be my witnesses. Where? Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, to the uttermost parts of the earth.
Nigerian minister E.A. Adeboye agrees, saying Africa is already seeing a tremendous move of God. He's witnessed many miracles, healings, and deliverances.
In the 21st century, we have all kinds of fake religion, New Age movements, all kinds of demonic operations. And I think there's only one way to confront this, and that's by the demonstration of the raw power of the Almighty God. And that can only be done through the baptism in the Holy Spirit.
Empowered 21 is a global congress, and it has definitely lived up to that name. Representatives from nearly 100 countries attended to witness the passing of the torch of Holy Spirit empowerment from one generation to the next.
I've never seen so many of the older generation, I'm talking about pastors, denominational leaders, engage, focus on, listen to, care about the younger generation. It's very refreshing.
They're stepping into the gap and saying, it's not about me anymore, it's about legacy. I'm not what I do, I'm what I leave behind.
Dr. Jack Hayford, a leader in four decades of charismatic renewal and revival, brought his grandson, who is also a pastor.
The most exciting thing to me is to be a part of this at my time of life, to be welcomed into it, and to be working with young leaders who have so much to bring to the table, and to see their passion and their quest for purity as well as the power of the Spirit.
Making sure this next generation is commissioned properly can turn around the waning of the movement in some circles. Swedish pastor Ulf Ekman, for example, has witnessed a decline.
Maybe not so much in the United States, but in many other places it's almost like the Pentecostal charismatics forgot the baptism of the Holy Spirit, moved into so many other things.
Dr. Samuel Rodriguez is concerned that non-ethnic Pentecostals in the U.S. are getting away from their heritage.
There has been a disconnect for a number of reasons. One of them has been the relativism, moral relativism, spiritual apathy.
Dr. Rodriguez says believers need to reconnect with the Holy Spirit so the apathy doesn't spread to this next generation.
Can we be spirit-friendly before we are seeker-friendly? We need to be friendly to the Spirit of God above all things. And then the seekers who are seeking Christ will see the reality of a powerful Christ.
The baptism in the Holy Spirit has been described as power for living. That's one reason Christian leaders here want to see that focus expanded to other areas like education.
And to me, that's the most important aspect, that the Holy Spirit is welcome to touch a life, a student's life, a staff member, a faculty, at any time.
The media.
The Spirit-filled life answers questions that I was just not getting answered. It allows me a certain discernment, a certain foresight, the ability to to maybe see things other people don't see.
And business.
The Holy Spirit's been my guide, you know, and so I look to Him to help me. Obviously, Christ is our Savior and Lord, but the Holy Spirit gives us that power to go forward.
And the generations represented here believe that power can help them change their world. Mark Martin, CBN News, Tulsa, Oklahoma.
For more stories on how God is moving in the U.S. and around the world, log on to our website at cbnnews.com. We'll be right back.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new dos. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new, or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt, but Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With the step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Welcome back. Well, good news for all you soda-drinking fans. The popular drink Mountain Dew has a new flavor coming out. It's called Distortion. The soft drink company held a contest for the new design of the can and bottle. Oklahoman Ben Stone submitted his artwork and won. He said it took about a month to design, and now his artwork and name is on all the bottles of the new drink. The new flavor is one of three that's being tested. The company says it will be letting people vote on which flavor they like best. Very democratic.
And finally, this hour on the news channel, a 12-year-old girl says the show SpongeBob SquarePants helped her to save her friend's life.
Miriam Starobin and Allison Golden were in this music class when Allison began choking on her gum. Miriam says she immediately remembered a SpongeBob episode where he does the Heimlich maneuver.
And Miriam, she goes, "Allie, are you choking?" And I go,
well, Miriam's Heimlich maneuver did the trick.
The gum flew out and Allison caught her breath. Oh, and by the way, no gum, candy, food is allowed in that class. And after this happened, the girl's music teacher said that SpongeBob can apparently save anyone's life.
Well, that's all for this hour of the CBN News Channel.
We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
Y todo era bueno. Nos creó para que le conociéramos.
Kutumbanga kalisimelsi undalani, ayana manalni srujinchadu.
Obwohl er jede Nation, jeden Volksstamm und jeden Menschen liebte,
nos apartamos de su amor. Nuestro pecado nos separó de él.
Но он не забыл нас. Иисус Христос оставил небеса, чтобы жить с нами.
Il a été cloué sur une croix. Et il est mort pour nos péchés.
Ananging, Gusti sampun wungu saking sedanipun lan gesang ing sak menika.
Yesus 快將再來，我哋期待呢一日。
But until then, we will share God's love in English.
In Espanol.
Auf Deutsch.
Français.
So every person might come to know our Savior, Jesus Christ the Lord.
Das ist unsere Mission.
Esa es nuestra pasión.
В этом наше будущее.
You're watching CBN News Channel. Available on the web 24/7 at cbnnewschannel.com.